Last week on This Bytes For You, we released a video on how to install the Gigabyte GeForce RTX 4090 Gaming OC graphics card. And in that video, we went to Gigabyte's site to download all the latest and greatest applications for the graphics card. Unfortunately, since the card just came out, they didn't have anything ready, but now they do. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to install that application, how to flash the firmware on the graphics card, and then how to control the graphics card with Gigabyte's utility. So let's get started. So here we're going to go to gigabyte.com. Then we're going to products, NVIDIA series, GeForce RTX 4090 Gaming OC 2400 support. And then down here we'll find BIOS and utility. I'm going to download the BIOS. It increases compatibility, but increases compatibility. It doesn't really say with what, so that's kind of vague. Does it increase compatibility with Cheerios, BMWs, bicycles? It doesn't really say. So let's find out. And then go to utility, and then we'll go download the Gigabyte Control Center. I'm on Windows 11, but it is compatible with Windows 11 and Windows 10, 64-bit. So with that, let's go ahead, show in folder. And we can close the browser, and we'll go first off into the utility, and definitely read this incredibly important, good stuff. And then I accept. Then the update is going to install RGB Fusion and Gigabyte VGA tool. Now I have RGB Fusion from the last time installed, but as you can see here, it updates it. I have 22.09.16.01 and the new version is 22.09.26.01. And I didn't have the Gigabyte VGA tool installed, so it installs that. So let's go ahead, install. And I don't know if it's installed. So then here we have the RGB Fusion, fan control, and performance, so some overclocking utilities. Definitely great to have, and I feel like now I have a little bit more freedom with the card. And then coming over here, file drop, not sure what this is just yet. And then we have the update, in case there's any updates. I'll go ahead and check it, none available. And then over here in the little gear, Gigabyte Control Center, automatically start with Windows, minimize, add RGB Fusion, and then home over here, which takes us back to this screen where we can control RGB Fusion or the fan, but we had that up here as well. Okay, so I'm gonna close this out real quick. Now let's go to the 4090 Go. I'm gonna right click, copy, and then paste it into the downloads folder. You never want to install more than one file from a zip file. This was fine because it only had one file. If it has more than one, you want to extract it and then run it from the extracted folder. So now in the extracted folder, 4090 Go, tool, and so switch the BIOS switch to OC side before booting. Run this one first, restart to complete the BIOS update, and then switch to the silent mode. So I'm gonna do that in that order. So let me go ahead, shut down, boot in overclocked mode, turn it back on, and we'll start it again. One sec. All right, so we're back in Windows with everything set to OC. So I'm gonna go ahead, close this out. Then we'll go into file manager, downloads, and 4090 Go tool. And one more time. So we want to go into GOA. Then we'll right click on it and run as administrator. More info and run anyway. BIOS mode does not match. Funny. So now we'll go to GOL, run as administrator, more info, run anyway. That's odd, but whatever. So are you sure you want to update your graphics BIOS? Yes. Okay, flash BIOS success. Would you reboot the system? Yes, I would reboot the system. So one quick sec while I reboot. Okay, that was a little scary, especially flashing the firmware on a video card. So we're back in Windows. And the command center opened up over here, minimized. So now I'm gonna go ahead, turn it off again. And now we're gonna flash the OC, non-OC. So one sec. Okay, so switching back over, now I'm in the non-OC, the silent mode, but not really because the BIOS got confused, I guess. Okay, so we'll come back over here and into downloads and 4090 go. And we did L, so let's do A now. The reverse of the reverse. Are you sure you want to update graphics BIOS? Yes. Flash BIOS success. Would you reboot the system? Yes. Yes, I would. Okay, so thankfully booting back up and we are back in Windows. So now we can open up the Gigabyte Control Center and we can see RGB Fusion correctly. So I'm going to go ahead, move the camera and show you correctly how RGB Fusion works. Okay, so we can see right over here, the Gigabyte is lit. And the fan blades will be lit. They're off right now. So we're going to go ahead and choose static and click apply. And also the fans are off right now because the fans stay off when the cards are below, I believe, 65 degrees. I'm not sure on the temperature just yet. So that's why they're not spinning. And let's see if I can go over to fan control. Okay, so I'm gonna set them to customized and click apply. Let's go ahead and okay, so now applying that, we can see the fan spinning at that orange kind of light. And we can raise and lower the brightness. That's live. And then, of course, if we wanted to, we can change speeds. And it looks like we can change lighting per fan, which that's pretty cool. Then also the Gigabyte logo, we can change that as well. So let's just reset all that, click apply. Now, coming to flash, you can see how those lights flash every few seconds. We can change the speed here and we can change the brightness as we saw before. Okay. And as before, we can always change the color. Okay, coming over to cycle, here it cycles through all of the colors. Actually, let me turn off the light real quick. Okay, so we can see those a little bit better now. And then coming over to gradient, so it's going to switch between white and red. Okay, dazzle. Dazzling through all of the colors. And off. Mind you, have the RGB on the entire system on, but I'm turning the card off. Pulse. Deflash. Color shift. And you don't have to hit apply. Out of habit, I'm doing that. Wave. And intelligent, whereas you can see right over here, the color changes based on the temperature. Okay, so we're done with RGB Fusion, so let's go over to fan control. Under fan control, if you remember, we're on auto mode, which we also have auto fan stop. We can just disable that if we'd like, and that'll go ahead and raise it to a higher temperature. I actually prefer that. I don't want my fans to stop. And you can see now that the fans are back on, the lights are back on. It's running at, well, it ran at 1,900 something RPMs, okay? And you can hear it's very quiet. They are spinning, but very low. So if I come over here to customized, let's go raise it up here. Not much louder. And so we can see the live RPMs right over here, and they went up, but it only got a little tiny bit louder. And now let's bump it up 100%. This one almost went up to, well, it passed 2,500 RPMs. Okay, so now let's go ahead and reset this. Put it to defaults. Okay, now raising the lights a little bit, I want to put this right over here so you could see the dB of the system now with the fans off. Okay, around 42 dB. Now mind you, the side panel is off, so it's going to be a little bit louder. We're right next to it. So now I'm going to move over to customized, and then I'm going to raise it to this line over here, and I'll wait till these fans ramp up. So we got about to, let's say, 46 dB. So I'm going to raise this to the half point. So that one hit about 48 degrees, and let's raise it to about 75%. So that one got a little bit louder, but not much. It's kind of drowned out by the overall system noise. Now let's just do 100%. So raising it to 100%, we hit about 53 dB. Still an incredibly quiet card for what it is. So I'm gonna go ahead and put that back to defaults and apply. Then over here under performance, we can boost the clock. We can do an OC scanner to overclock it. We can raise the GPU voltage, the power limit, the temperature limit, and the memory speed. I'm gonna go ahead and stay away from that performance since it will differ from system to system. But if that's something you actually want me to show you, go ahead and let me know down in the comments below. So in this video, I've shown you how to install the Gigabyte Control Center, then also how to flash the firmware on both OC and silent mode on the graphics card. Then I've shown you how to utilize RGB Fusion to change all the lighting on your graphics card, and then how to use the fan control so that you can ramp up your fans as high as you want to go or keep them as low as you want to go. I'd recommend to get rid of that auto that it turns it off and put it somewhere in the midpoint, maybe 50%, something like that, and then let that slide up as high as possible, as I showed you a little bit earlier. So let me know what you think about this video. Did you enjoy it? Did you find it helpful? And then also earlier in the video, I linked up the installation of this card, but if you haven't seen it just yet, go ahead and check out this link up above, and that way it'll take you directly to it. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, as always, leave them down below. I reply to all of them. Iggy with ThisBytesForYou up. See you guys.